From this video, I would like to explain how to draw the graphs of the given polynomials that are from class 10, third chapter, polynomials, exercise 3.2, third question, 2 and 3 problems from AP and Telangana state boards. These are graphs of quadratic polynomials are very important problems for 4 marks questions. These are compulsory problems, so we will concentrate and learn perfectly these problems. The problems are, first one is draw the graph of the given polynomial and find the zeros, justify the answer. The second one is p of x is equals to x square minus 6x plus 9. And third one is p of x is equals to x square minus 4x plus 5. I will explain these two problems now. Hi, this is Madhu Babu. In third question, second problem is draw the graph of the polynomial p of x is equals to x square minus 6x plus 9 and find the zeros, justify the answer. Solution: first given polynomial is p of x is equals to x square minus 6x plus 9. To draw the graph, we need some order pairs, that means points. To take the points in this question, here 5 problems are there. Here, these 5 problems not having same order pairs. So, different problems, different order pairs will be there. So, to find the perfect order pairs, first of all, it is better to find the zeros of this polynomial. This is a quadratic polynomial. This is, so do rough work to take the points. So, verification, to take the order pairs, leave some space here and do verification here. To take the points, here only x is there, only variable x is there. So, we need y, take p of x as y. So, let y is equals to x square minus 6x plus 9. So, this is the quadratic polynomial. In this place y, take 0 to get verification, then x square minus 6x plus 9 is equals to 0, then it will be quadratic equation. By using factorization method or quadratic form also, we can find the zeros of the variable. Then only we can take the order pairs, that means points, easily. So here, first of all, we should multiply the coefficient of x square and the constant term. So, here coefficient of x square term is 1 and constant term is 9. So, 1 into 9 is equals to 9. Take the factors of 9 in order. 9 factors. We can write as 1 into 9 or minus 1 into minus 9, and also 3 into 3 or minus 3 into minus 3. These are the all possible factors in combination. So, in splitting method, to get minus 6, the x coefficient is minus 6. In splitting method, to get minus 6, in this combination of factors, after adding these factors, we should get minus 6. So we will check 1 plus 9, that is equals to 9, after adding these factors. So this is not suitable combination to get minus 6. And minus 1 plus minus 9, this total is minus 10 after the, so this is not suitable. And 3 plus 3, in this combination 3 plus 3 is equals to 6, so this is also not suitable to get minus 6. After adding these two factors, minus 3 into minus 3, 9, and also after adding we get to minus 6. So this is only suitable combination factors. So write minus 3 into minus 3 is equals to 9. After adding these terms, we will get minus 6. So to write minus 6, here x square, write minus 6x as minus 3x plus of minus 3x. That means again minus 3x by using these combination factors. So plus 9 is equals to 0. In these two terms, x is common. So common x, remaining terms in x square, x only. In 3x, 3 will be remain. Minus 3x plus 9. In minus 3x plus 9, 3 table will cancel. So common minus 3. Remaining in this term, x. To get plus, write here minus. Then after multiplication, minus into minus, it will be plus. So it is perfect. 3 in 9, 3 times. After multiplication of these terms, we should get the above equation. We will check x into x, x square, plus into minus, minus, x into 3, 3x, minus 3 into x, minus 3x, minus into minus, plus, 3, 3s are 9. So what we did is write. In this both terms, common term is x minus 3, first common it, and remaining terms, write x minus 3 like this, is equals to 0. X minus 3 is equals to 0, and x minus 3 is equals to 0. Send minus 3 that side, then it will be minus 3 will be plus 3. So x is equals to 3, and plus, and send minus 3 that side will get same, x is equals to 3. So here only is the 0 of this polynomial. So only one 0, that is the 3. So to take the points, that means order pairs, first you write 3 here. The preceding integer of 3 is 2, write that, take that one to get perfect diagram. And the succeeding integer of this 3 is 4. So in this, for this problem, these 3 values enough in the place of x. So take the tabular form, this 3, if this 3 values in x, we will get the perfect diagram of this polynomial. So take the tabular form. First one is x. Second, to find the y value, that is y is equals to x square minus 6x plus 9. Next, x comma y, the order pair. So take the first value 2. Next 3. Next value 4. Substitute in that one. First you substitute the value in the place of x in this equation, then we will get y value. Y is equals to, substitute in the place of x, 2, take 2 first term, 2 square minus 6 into in x plus 2 plus 9, then it will be 2 square value 4, 6 2s are 12 plus 9. After adding the 4 plus 9, plus value is 13, 13 minus 12, that is equals to 1. So for 2, y value is 1, this is one order pair. And substitute 3 in this equation, y is equals to 3 square minus 6 into 3 plus 9, then that will be 9 minus 18 plus 9. The plus values are 9 plus 9, 18, negative value 18, 18 minus 18, 0. So for 3, my value is 0. Already we did verification in that one, the 0 of this polynomial is 3. So for this value of 3, we got 0. That is 0 of the polynomial. So what we did is write and substitute 4 in this equation. Y is equals to 4 square minus 6 into 4 plus 9, that is equals to 16 minus 24 plus 9. 16 plus 9, 25 minus 24, that is equals to 1. So for 4 we'll get 1. So these 3 order pairs enough to find the zeros of the polynomial from this graph. Next, come to the graph. By observing these are the very smallest values, 2, 3, 4 on y-axis, y coordinates 1, 0, 1. So take in the middle of the graph, take x-axis and y-axis, and take 1 centimeter as 1 unit on both axes. Like this. First order pair is 2 comma 1. So for 2, y value is 1. So substitute this one. This is the first point. For 2, this is the point 2 comma 1. And next point is 3 comma 0. So x 3, y 0. So this is the 3 comma 0 point. And for 4 comma 1. So for 4 comma 1, this is the value. So draw the graph in order 2 comma 1. Locate these points. Next, this is 3 comma 0. This point is 4 comma 1. So in order you join these points, the graph of the polynomial, quadratic polynomial, is the parabola. Parabola is a curve. So without using scale, in order you join by hand only. So this is the required graph. These points enough to take this one. This is y is equals to x square minus 6x plus 9. And write the scale. We took 1 centimeter as 1 unit on x-axis and 1 centimeter as 1 unit on y-axis. So this is the scale. One centimeter as 1 unit on x-axis, 1 centimeter as 1 unit on y-axis. In this problem, draw the graph of the polynomial p of x is equals to x square minus 6x plus 9 is completed. And from this graph, we have to find the zeros. We have to find the zeros. How can we find? First of all, the graph intersects the x-axis at 3 comma 0. So the zeros of the polynomial are the points where the graph intersects the x-axis. In that points, x coordinates are called zeros of the polynomial. So from this graph, the graph intersects the x-axis at 3 comma 0. In this point, x coordinate is 3. So the zero of the polynomial is 3. So write these steps. The graph intersects the x-axis at 3 comma 0. So in this point, x coordinate is 3. So that is the zero of the polynomial. Therefore, for this problem, the zero of the polynomial is only 3, and the problem is not completed. And justify the answer. How can we justify? How can we justify the answer? Here, the graph, the x coordinates of the points where the graph intersects the x-axis, that they are the called GRS of the polynomial. So I conclude that the zeros of the polynomial are the x coordinates of the points where the graph means the shape where the graph intersects the x-axis. So the problem second one is finished in third question, and let us go to the next question, third one. The third question is, draw the graph of the polynomial p of x is equals to x square minus 4x plus 5, and find the zeros, justify the answer. Same question. Solution: given polynomial p of x is equals to x square minus 4x plus 5. To locate the points, we need y variable also. So let p of x is equals to y, then it will be y is equals to x square minus 4x plus 5. So let y is equals to x square minus 4x plus 5. To take the order pairs points, it will be little bit confusing. So it is better to find the zeros of the polynomial by using factorization method or quadratic form. Then only we take the points easily. Like previous problem, you leave some space. Verification: let y is equals to 0, then it will be x square minus 4x plus 5 is equals to 0. For x square minus, do rough work, x square minus 4x plus 5 is equals to 0. First of all, multiply coefficient of x square, that is 1, and constant term, that is 5. 1 into 5, 5. Take the 5 factors. 5 factors we can write as 1 into 5 or minus 1 into minus 5. Only these are two ways. So to get minus 4, the coefficient of x, that is minus 4, to get minus 4 in these factors, after adding this combination of factors, we should get minus 4. We will check it. Here two factors are there, 1 plus 5. After adding these factors, we will get 6. So this is not suitable. So after adding this combination, minus 1 plus of minus 5, we will get minus 6. So in this both ways, we will not get minus 4. So for this problem, the quadratic polynomial has no real zeros. So by factorization method, we cannot find the zeros. So we will use quadratic form. So a value is 1, b value is minus 4, c value is 5. What is the quadratic form? Every quadratic form, generally they have two zeros. So let the two zeros will be alpha comma beta. This is formula, that is minus b plus or minus. To find the zeros using this formula, this is called quadratic form. Minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So substitute these values, minus b, that value minus of minus 4, plus root of minus 4 whole square minus 4ac, 4 into 1 into 5 by 2a, 2 into 1, minus of minus 4 plus 4, plus or minus root of 4 square, 16, 4 once 4, 4 5 is 20, by 2 once 2. Next, 4 plus or minus 16 minus 20, that is root of minus 4 by 2. Actually, this is in root minus 4 is there. So this is called, we cannot simplify this value. We cannot write the same factors. So this is called imaginary number. Imaginary number. This is real, this is imaginary. So this type of numbers are not real numbers. So the quadratic polynomial has no real zeros. But by using leave this imaginary and leave this plus or minus, just 4 by 2. So 4 by 2 value after neglect this value, this is imaginary, take the real numbers only, 4 by 2 value 2. So take first 2 and preceding 2 more numbers between, before this 2 number, before integers are 1 and 0. For this 2, after succeeding numbers are 3 and 4. So by taking these values in the place of x, we will get the order pairs and we will get perfect diagram for this given quadratic polynomial. I think, do you understand? Just leave the imaginary number and take 4 by 2 only, 4 by 2 value 2. So this is the important value, and take 2 more values in before the 2, and after 2 take 2 more values. Then these values are enough to draw the graph. So form a tabular form. X and y is equals to x square minus 4x plus 5, and order pair is x comma y. First is substitute 0 is y is equals to 0 square minus 4 into 0 plus 5, that is equals to 0 square value 0, 4 zeros are 0 plus 5, 0 minus 0, 0, 0 plus 5, 5. So for 0, the y value is 5. And substitute 1 in the place of x. Y is equals to 1 square minus 4 into 1 plus 5. That is equals to 1 square value 1 minus 4, 1s are 4 plus 5. The values, positive values 1 plus 5, 6. Negative value minus 4, 6 minus 4 is equals to 2. So for 1, the value of y is 2. Next is substitute 2 in the place of x. Y is equals to 2 square minus 4 into 2 plus 5. That is equals to 2 square value 4. 4 2s are 8 plus 5. Adding positive values 4 plus 5, 9. 9 minus 8 is equals to 1. So for 2, the value of y is 1. Next, substitute 3 in the place of x. Y is equals to 3 square minus 4 into 3 plus 5. 3 square 9, 4 3s are 12 plus 5. Plus values 9 plus 5, that is equals to 14 minus 12, that value is 2. So 3 comma 2, and substitute 4. Y is equals to 4 square minus 4 into 4 plus 5. 4 square is 16 minus 4, 4s are 16 plus 5. Plus 16 minus 16 will cancel. So 5 is remainder. So the point is 4 comma 5. So observe this x coordinates, very small these are. So take 1 centimeter as 1 unit on x axis, and observe the y coordinates of these points. These are also very small integers. So take 1 centimeter as 1 unit on y-axis also. So take like this, 1 centimeter as 1 unit on x-axis and 1 centimeter as 1 unit on both y-axis also. So plot these points in order. First one 0 comma 5. So for 0, the y value is 5. So this is the first point, 0 comma 5. Second point 1 comma 2. For 1, the y value 2. So this is represents 1 comma 2. For 2, 2 comma 1. So for 2, this is represents 2 comma 1. And for 3, 3 comma 2, 3 comma 2 again. So 3 comma 2. And 4 comma 5, 4 comma 5. This is a p of x is equals to x square minus 4x plus 5 is a quadratic polynomial. So the representation of quadratic polynomial on the graph is parabola. So in order, in this order only you join these points by hand. Parabola is a curve, so don't use scale, and by hand only you join these points in order. By using pencil you join. So this is the required graph of the polynomial, that is equals to y is equals to x square minus 4x plus 5, and plot the points. This is 0 comma 5. Scale on x-axis 1 centimeter as 1 unit, and also on y-axis 1 centimeter as 1 unit. The graph of this problem is completed, but problem is not completed. Draw the graph of the polynomial p of x is equals to x square minus 4x plus 5 is completed. This is the diagram, graph, and find the zeros. How can we find the zeros of the polynomial from the graph? Means the zeros of the polynomials are x coordinates of the points where the graph intersects the x-axis. So here the graph does not intersect the x-axis at any point. So write that one. The graph does not intersect the x-axis at any point. So the quadratic polynomial has no real zeros. The quadratic polynomial has real zeros. And justify the answer. How can we justify the answer? Means the zeros of the polynomial are the x coordinates of the points where the graph intersects the x-axis. So I noticed that the zeros of the polynomial are the x coordinates of the points, x coordinates of the points where the graph intersects the x-axis. So here the graph does not intersect the x-axis. So the graph, the quadratic polynomial has no real zeros. So this is the graphical representation of the problem. If you like this video, please like it and share it to those who need math basics, and subscribe for more videos. Thank you for watching.